in subjection under these said people. Alright? So we're constantly the spirit got us on you devils, man. You know? The spirit got it on you devils, man. We constantly gonna continue to slice and dice you with this two-edged sword, man. Okay. We gonna come against anything that exalts itself against the knowledge of the Lord, man.
That's right.
We gonna break down all strongholds through the spirit and power of Yahweh by Shem Yahushua.
Right.
Starting with the apostles, a great millstone on down to the brothers.
Right.
Okay. And you opened up a Pandora's box, man. When you came on the scene, you opened up a can of you opened up Chevron shit. You know?
Can of whoop ass.
You know? Devils, you can't wither your way out of judgment. And the Gentiles, it's beautiful. That whole Gentile topic been coming up for weeks. And we've been dealing with that, man. A lot of devils will always come up and always want to see their lot in the salvation. Well, did the Lord make a covenant with you? Because that's what it boils down to. The Lord is only addressing who he's made covenants with. Throughout the Bible, the only people the Lord made a covenant with was the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
Them the only people that he was speaking to. He wasn't speaking to white people. He wasn't speaking to Arabs. He wasn't speaking to the Moabite, the Chinese, the Japanese. You're the heathen nations.
That's right.
He never made a covenant with you, man. Okay? We never made a covenant with you. All right? You have something you want to do?
Second Exodus 6. Second Exodus chapter 6, verse 54. And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures, of him come we all.
Yep.
So you think it just because we all come from the same progenitor, all the way back from Adam, we should have, that doesn't have nothing to do with that. It says, and the people also whom thou hast chosen, that made a divide out of all the people of the earth to just the chosen people right there. All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sakes.
Yep.
As for the other people, another division from his chosen and the other people, which also come of Adam, thou hast said that they are nothing, but be like unto spittle, and has likened them to the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
Hey, what's funny is, even though that's scripture, that devil James White, he discredits the Apocrypha. But he doesn't believe that that's inspired by the Lord, but we can read the same thing out of the Tanakh, out of the prophets.
Yep.
You don't believe the prophets, if we bring it out from the prophets? I mean, that's just him being, these heathens are desperate, man. They really don't want to have to eat. They don't want to have to drink of the cup, man.
You will surely drink.
You will surely drink it, man.
Big gulps.
Yep. 57. Says, and now, O Yahweh, behold, these heathen, which have ever, see how he called everybody else a heathen, but his own chosen people. He said, these heathen, which thou have ever reputed as nothing, have begun to be lords over us and to devour us. That's still going on today. He said, but we, thy people, whom thou hast called thy firstborn, thy only begotten, and thy fervent lover. In that Bible, it calls us all those things. Right? It says, are given into their hands. If the world be made for our sakes, why do we not possess an inheritance with the world? How long shall this endure? How come we ain't on the level? If we all in the kingdom of heaven, how come we all on the bottom of society? Is it our fault that we're in the kingdom of heaven and that we're on the bottom? If that's what you're saying that it is, that the Lord's already come. that has not happened yet. That has not happened. We're his chosen people, which never changes. All y'all, he don't care about. That's period point blank. No ifs, ands, or buts, or no's. You have to change your understanding to believe something else. You make the scriptures say something else.
That's right. And if you don't believe the apocrypha, it's certain. The proof that it's canonical, the book of Baruch, is spoken of in the prophet of Jeremiah, man. You know? Because he discredits the apocrypha, but the real reason why you discredit the apocrypha is because it exposes you devils to a T. The history that you never wanted to get out, it's exposed in that book. You know? It shows you who the Edomites are, and in the apocrypha, it links who the Idumeans are with the Greeks and the Romans. Okay? And that was information that you devils didn't want to get out there. That's why, and it's spiritual, the apocrypha means to be sent away hidden. Okay, so it was spiritual why this book was taken out of the original text. All right? It was supposed to be a secret of the Lord, but the Lord brought that secret out unto his servants. All right, the Lord put the spirit out for them to get this. Because this is also part of the word of the Most High. Jeremiah, I think it's the 46th chapter, if I'm not mistaken.
Baruch 1:1. And these are the words of the book which Baruch the son of Neris and son of Messias and the son of Sadducees. And Sadducees and the son of Odysseus and the son of Chalicius wrote in Babylon in the fifth year of the seventh day of the month, what time the Chaldeans took Jerusalem and burnt it with fire.
So this is showing you that in that time period, this was during the time of ancient Babylon, the ancient Babylonian captivity. And the prophets that were on the scene at that time was a prophet Jeremiah, a prophet Daniel, prophet Isaiah, and so on and so forth. And those were the prophets back then. Now, this is the Apocrypha, in which a portion of that book is written. Baruch was pretty much a scribe for the prophet Jeremiah. And it's going to prove it. You go to Jeremiah. You got that?
Jeremiah 45:1. The word that Jeremiah the prophet spake unto Baruch, the son of Neriah.
Now go back to that.
This is the same
Baruch. Go ahead.
These are the words of the book which Baruch the son of Neriah.
Go back to Jeremiah 45.
This is Jeremiah 45:1. The word that Jeremiah the prophet spake unto Baruch the son of Neriah. When he had written these words in a book.
Okay, so this is how you get the book of Baruch. All right, because the Lord was speaking through Jeremiah the words to give unto his scribe Baruch. Okay, and when you read in 2 Ezra 15, where it talks about cause these prophecies to be written in paper for their faithful and true, that's how we get the prophecies of the books. Okay, all the prophets had scribes; they had writers. All right, and the Lord is the one, the Heavenly Father, who gave the inspiration of those words to be written on those scrolls. And that's how we got them today, in the form of a book. Okay?
Okay, this is how we're talking about the validity
of the Apocrypha, yeah.
Right. This is the song of the three holy children. It comes out of the book of Daniel. It says, which followeth in the third after this place fell down bound into the midst of the burning fiery furnace, verse 23, said, there was love is not in, the Hebrew to wit, and they walked unto these words. Then Nebuchadnezzar, verse 24, so it's in between verse 23 and 24. The history of Susanna set apart from the beginning of Daniel, because it is not in the Hebrew, as neither the narration of Bela the Dragon. Now I'm going to say Bela the Dragon also, right? Cut off from the end of that. Now, verse 39 in Bela the Dragon says this, so Daniel arose and did eat, and the angel of the Lord said, Habakkuk, which is a book in that regular Bible, right? In his own place again, because he sent Habakkuk to feed Daniel. When he was in the last day, I'm looking if I could just get the point on 34. But the angel of the Lord said unto Habakkuk, go and carry dinner that thou hast into Babylon unto Daniel, who is in the lion's den. And Habakkuk said, Lord, I never saw Babylon, neither do I know where the den is. You know, so they're basically talking about when Daniel's in the lion's den. That's in the other Bible. And the one that they, after the apocalypse, will be taken out. You go to the 1611, and it's still in there, without the letter J.
Go to Jeremiah 36. Did you read it? Would you finish that in the 45th? I mean,
45.
You finished that already?
No, he had 45.
Okay. Finish that verse, and then go to Jeremiah 36.
This is Jeremiah 45:1. The word that Jeremiah the prophet spake unto Baruch, the son of Neriah, when he had written these words in a book at the mouth of Jeremiah in the fourth year of Jehoiakim, and the son of Josiah, king of Judah, saying, thus saith the Most High, the power of Israel unto thee, O Baruch.
36, and start at the top.
This is Jeremiah 36:1. And it came to pass in the fourth year of Jehoiakim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, that this word came unto Jeremiah from the Most High, saying, take thee a roll of a book, and write therein all the words that I have spoken unto thee against Israel.
So prophet Jeremiah, he told his scribe Baruch, write everything that I command you, write it down. All right, write it down in a scroll so we can have a book. Compose these writings in a book. And that's what happened with all the prophets. Okay? So this is proving the validity of the Apocrypha. Baruch is a book within the Apocrypha. Okay? And this is just one example.
Hey, yeah, right, because the rest of Esther. The rest of Esther, there's a part of Esther that's cut out of this book. Edras is Ezra, which is in the other book. Edras is the big term versus Ezra. Because some of these were written in Greek. Some of them chose Greek as their tongue. So some of them spoke and wrote in Greek. Because when they switched it over, they took it out.
Oh, yeah, talking about translating.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Because it was written in Greek and they didn't have the Hebrew of it, they took it out.
Yeah. You got you still in Jeremiah?
Take thee, this is Jeremiah 36:2. Take thee a roll of a book and write therein all the words that I have spoken unto thee against Israel. And against Judah, and against all the nations, from the day I spake unto thee, from the days of Josiah, even unto this day.
Yep. The time of Josiah, right? So you got to go into the history, man. When we was in captivity under the Babylonians, who was one of the Babylonian rulers? Nebuchadnezzar. Okay. So this was around that time period.
This is Jeremiah 36:4. Then Jeremiah called Baruch the son of Neriah, and Baruch wrote from the mouth of Jeremiah all the words of the Most High, which he has spoken.
All the words of the Most High. He wrote down all the words of the Most High. Okay? So he's pinning down the words of the Heavenly Father. The Most High is having him ghostwrite his word as he's speaking through Prophet Jeremiah.
Okay? This is Jeremiah 36 and 4. Then Jeremiah called Baruch, the son of Neriah, and Baruch wrote from the mouth of Jeremiah all the words of the Most High, which he has spoken unto him upon the roll of the book.
And what was that? It was pretty much concerning the prophecy of this that particular Babylon, where our people were enslaved, but also future prophecy of this Babylon. Okay? So when you go into the book of Baruch, you're reading prophecy from the Most High.
Okay.
All right? Where it talks about when we go into slavery, there shall we think upon the name of our Lord. That's referring to now. Okay? We're in the land of our captivity here in Babylon, and we calling upon the name of our Heavenly Father to deliver us. No? But devils like James White is not for him. So he'll say some dumb shit like, well, the Apocrypha is canonical. It was not inspired by God. You know, it was a reason why it was omitted. You know, it was, or they'll say it was added or whatever. You know, the Catholics, Catholics, they threw that up in there. But King James, it's in his original edition, and he didn't like Catholics. King James didn't get along with the Catholics, you know?
I'll tell you some real shit, though. I'm looking at a lot of the videos.
You're soaking it in, huh?
Translations diligently compared and revised by His Majesty's special command appointed to be read in churches. Talk about King James, the Majesty. You know, the same King James Version. It fits with the same thing. And then it all lines up, and the understanding of it still lines up. The codes still line up.
Yeah, like, you won't read nothing out of the Apocrypha that's going to contradict the Old Testament and the New Testament.
Right.
You ain't going to read nothing out of the Apocrypha that's going to contradict the Gospels, man, or the prophecies.
Only your understanding or lack thereof will contradict.
Right.
Your lack of understanding will contradict the books. But y'all struggling with just this one Bible, though.
Yeah.
Just the basic 17, whatever this is, you know. You got the unit anymore. But y'all struggling with that one.
Yeah. Yeah, man. So, I mean, you can't just, hey, man. This is why you nations, man, you going down, man. You know?
It ain't
meant for y'all, man. Y'all should just put the Bible down, man. Y'all have nothing to do with this.
If you want to learn about the Bible, come to Great Millstone and ask us, and we'll answer your questions and deliver your judgment.
Yeah.
Hey, that's the best thing you got to do. That's what a smart, humble man would do.
That's it.
He will attain to wise counsels. Great Millstone is a wise counsel.
Yeah. Hey, and
those that have the understanding.
And another thing. And that dude, that Alize, you know, we don't fuck with him, but I watched a video where he cut into y'all about how y'all try to omit or claim that the Apocrypha has no validity. But where did the Lord get the Feast of Dedications from? Where does that come from? Because you ain't gonna find a Feast of Dedication.